Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is Engine News with the latest updates from the Angular community in 100 seconds every week. Alex Rickabaugh, tech lead of the Angular framework, and Ben Lesh, maintainer of RxJs, had a discussion on TechStackNation about signals and observables. That is a topic very interesting also outside of Angular, because both signals and observables are considered to become a standard in JavaScript. In terms of difference, RxJS is strong when it comes to handling events and asynchronous tasks. Signals are good when it comes to managing state.
The signals where you got state and like your signal state and you've got computed properties and you're binding them out to a view, very easy to reason about, top to bottom, left to right. There's your state management. Do not use RxJS for state management.
The monthly Q&A session with Jeremy and Mark from the Angular team happened again. Next to the typical discussions, why signals, why not stick to RxJS? We also learned that the web test runner, which will be the successor of Karma, will not be available in Angular 18. By default, a component is not standalone unless its standalone property is set to true. That is going to change.
At some point in the not too distant future, we will change the standalone flag to be true by default. And so if you leave it out, that will be true, and you have to explicitly set it to false.
The two major Austrian Angular meetups, Vienna and Graz, happened at the same time. The talks were recorded, so you can choose among the topics like accessibility, security, change detection, performance, or design systems. And that's it. Wishing you a nice week. See you in the next episode. Goodbye.